Seconds remaining. Radiant team Virtus.Pro's turn to pick.
Stalker and Beastmaster.
Stalker
Double Iron Talon. Slark here.
Radiant team back.
Probably Slark or Gyro.
Yeah,
I can.
Reserve time.
I mean, nice job. Yeah, the panels are noobs. They don't understand. I mean, Night Stalker, Sark has night vision. Yeah. That's why he's so good here. Panel sucks. I'm firing them all. Thank you, Nahaz, here with Ryu again. Now the panel, again unanimous on the decision for Vici Game Reborn. None of them even care to bother for VP.
I care about VP. I'm going to pick VP then. How about that, guys? And the panel didn't notice something that we did. They didn't really talk about the Beastmaster and Nightstalker kind of countering act each other. And I like that last pick because it's going to be nighttime a lot more. And what Stark provides is that extra vision here in the match. And that's going to help them a lot when they're trying to dodge ganks. Because as long as you're fast on the Q, yeah, sure, they have a lot of lockdowns. But I can see this working out for the Stark if he has the Ion Shell on top of him. Sure, there are a lot of magic damage bursts. But with that Spectre last pick, they, like Fog talked about, they don't have the really big BKB carrier, and so I think VP are going to be able to roll them with the spell damage, but that's not to say that these picks are still very strong from VG.R right now. They're going to be constantly running at you. I mean, I could just see VP getting rolled fast here, but We'll have to see.
Who do you think the laning stage is more critical for in this particular matchup? I mean, I tend to side with probably for Vici game Reborn that they're going to have to just make sure they can keep things safe, have the Spectre continue to farm up, and avoid the pressure from someone like the Earth Spirit. But does that mean that Virtus.Pro need to make sure they can succeed in being extra aggressive in the laning phase, or do you think that it's something completely different?
I think you just need to try to make sure you can shut down the Beastmaster as much as possible in this offlane for VP so they don't have all their utilities. But, I mean, we're going to see an Iron Talon FY Night Stalker here. This is going to be very scary roaming around once that first night comes in. Yeah, it's going to be on that. Once that first night hits, how much can VG.R get done for me? And then, obviously, the second night's probably going to be where, you know, this mid-game is kind of decided.
We'll see how things do decide to pan out here. You do have the pressure of the early Ion Chill Earth Spear potentially coming on way as he got that early Orb of Venom, so expect him to kind of dish out the continuous pressure. Never an easy target, though, when you're going against someone like the Puck here, so I'm going to be keeping close eyes here to see how No Fear is going to decide to kind of change up where he wants to make an approach, probably more so towards the bottom lane. If anything, he'll go for the first roll and hope to swing and miss. Hey, almost a free courier. He'll just try his best to keep Mikasa's zone back a bit and allow G to get that big boost of CS.
Oh, you just saw that lane block coming out from the Earth Spirit, and whereas Mikasa got no help. This is just unfair right now.
It's pretty much a full wave lost right here at the start, and that is a huge
Clark pounced already.
Yeah, they make it go for FNG actually on the bottom here. They get a nice stun. He even pops up the salve there at the end. First blood going to be going away for Vici Gaming Reborn as they do strike first.
Yeah, I'm glad you saw that because I was watching top lane as Yang was getting gone onto. Yoku made the pounce and Aloha taking a lot of heavy right clicks. But there you go. That's how you can punish the Darkseer, just playing a little bit too aggressive here. And I was very surprised Nofir maybe didn't start off in the bottom lane.
He's here now though, and he has that Island Shell and FNG.
Top lane.
Love to have the assistance here. And
they're just softening them
lane.
Up.
Whenever they can connect that pounce, this should be two Purifying Flames. And that is going to be a nice little pick off there. Yoku will pick up the last hit. That's the thing. I mean, Purifying Flames, even a level 1, does some respectable nuking damage, but it's the low cooldown. And if you have a pounce, that's easily 2, maybe even 3.
Oh, there we go, gank.
Roll connection going to be happening here for DDC. And now Nofir begins to go to work with help of the Iron Shell. They have the damage, but it's a 3-on-1. They even give him the surge. They want it so bad, but they are not going to get it. They will lose the red on this.
Oh, bad for FNG.
He does not have a surge. He cannot make it away. Will this be back-to-back takedowns of the Darkseer? Well, he's like, I'm going to head for the freaking trees and try my best to juke here. Has the surge now. FY will continue to scout him on out. DDC not going to get hit with a Sunstrike. A roll in from No Fear is again going to be a miss.
Fear.
Oh, we'll be back-to-back takedowns onto him. He gets a surge save from FNG, and man, all these lanes, high tensions.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. FNG didn't have the double Ion Shell, and he would really love to have level 3. That's when you start dishing out a ton of damage with the double Ion, but yeah, No Fear is swinging a miss in this early game, but as we see, sometimes you miss those early. But once he gets level 6, you just see that magnetize and how they can be MVPs of fights.
Definitely makes it a lot easier if you're able to kind of get off those early rolls to boost up the XP and get to that level 6 much sooner. Because otherwise, and Earth Spirit is not a farming hero. Not at all. So you're planning on farming heroes.
Yep. And I want to say he's only level 1 right now. This is...
It's very standard when you don't land those rolls. So he'll just have to find his own way to recover a bit. The Iron Shells will begin to level up, and it'll make his job a bit easier whenever he wants to look and engage.
But yeah, it was a nice play coming in from FY, not just starting off in the jungle, else they would have gotten rolled in the bottom lane if they didn't have the Night Stalker support there.
Uh-oh, Yang could be in trouble. They're going to lead off early. Purifying Flames, they catch him with a stun, makes it easy for the pounce connection there for Yoku. Another Purifying Flames, and there it is. A right click should come out, and they're going to get the kill. No Fear is like, please let me have the XP. Tries to roll in for it. But another good little gank maneuver, and as they punish Yang in the offlane once more.
Man, Aloha is just making Oracle look broken right now. He is just on fire, and it helps. Oh, meanwhile, I was just denying. Okay. But it's just playing it so effectively, softening up the target there early on.
Yeah.
And just great play. And then Yoku, this is going to help him out a lot. It's going to be curious to see what he goes for. I mean, is he going to go, you know, that greedy Midas route?
Is the lane going that punished? Well, or are you going for something like the Midas here? I mean, you really put it past him.
Well, we'll see soon, because either you rush the Midas now or you should get Aquila, like, just for that extra mana sustain in the lane.
Well, you do already have the Aquila built up here for G. He went with, again, that Arteezy kind of invoker efficiency buildup.
I think you still need it on the Slark eventually. Like, you just need that mana regen desperately, and as well as the stats are always nice.
They both could end up having a pretty similar item build if G also goes for the Midas. So it could put VP in a situation where they're going to be playing things a bit greedy early on. Will be on VG Gaming Reborn to kind of punish him for it. So FY heads to the jungle once again. This time he will have the Iron Talon, of course, and begins the grind up a farm. The Nightfall is down here, so how much pressure is it on him to be able to kind of use this first nighttime to get some early pickoffs?
Well, because he had to help the bottom lane early on, he's kind of forced now to get that level 4. I mean, Nightstalker is very scary when you have that silence to work with, but other than that, it's going to be it has to have a nice, like, kind of dream coil to set it up. We're looking at Spectre now, still not level 6. Once that's online, we could see ZYF getting very active, and that's when the pressure is going to have to come. We haven't really touched here on the mid lane, Dakota. It's pretty much even, like, 22 last hits for the Puck, as well as, you know, 29 for the Invoker. I would say that's pretty good for Mikasa, all things considered. We talk about him being a little bit weak in the lane stage, but he's been doing a very good job against an Invoker, as well as G, so.
Uh-oh. Yang might be in trouble here. No Fear is rotating in from behind.
He's got TP.
He's now level 3. And he actually went with a 1-1-1
build up here.
He kicked very early. The roll is not going to be there. Typically, you want to roll in, get the scout out, and yeah, reserve the stun in case of something like that. But Yang will be able to make it back to base. It still gets
out of the lane. Mid.
Yeah, they get the coil committed. It is going to snap. Mikasa jumps in with the help of the orb and FY there to assist. Rotation from No Fear, but he still doesn't have that stun. In fact, he
didn't
even look for a double up here. Yeah, he didn't even use the grip. Okay. Oh, commitment in from the Haunt from Spectre on this one. FY? He's running up and around right here. He's going to look to make a move. He jumps in, has still one more urn to work with, gets it onto him, and I think this is going to be a kill. It certainly will be. The urn will tick through, and it is a killing spree already for the FY Nightstalker. This guy is Dracula.
Yeah, he's got his urn, too. This is just looking very bad for VP, but this is kind of to be expected from VG.R at their first nighttime and their first haunt. So as long as they can just weather the storm here, get their levels up, and just starting to get active. Because that's really weird for me. Earth Spirit TP's in and doesn't silence the lion. Like, he had ample opportunity to do it, and he didn't go for the standard, right? He didn't go for the 2 points and stuns because he's like, okay, well, they have a lot of potential, you know, spells that can be thrown mid lane. They're dying.
Oh, jump behind. It's going to push G to run south, but he is completely surrounded here, and they just absolutely slaughter him. G's going to be taken down, and VG Gaming Reborn on an absolute assault in the early game, making the most out of this first nighttime.
That's the problem that you can see. You're just going to get run at constantly for the Invoker mid lane, and they don't have the necessary, you know, levels on their supports to really help him out at the moment. So he's just going to have to weather the storm, probably go back into the jungle and farm would have been nice for the Invoker. I mean, but you can see it, at the same time, this tower is going to get taken down here very shortly, I feel, for VGR.
Yeah.
They're going to take it.
This does put G in a bit of an awkward situation, and as you mentioned, like, where he can find the recovery farm for himself. Let's go back and touch base here with the bottom lane where we have FNG. He is now level 6, looking to push up to near level 7. He's got plenty of iron shells to work with here, so maybe him and No Fear should kind of get back together at this point. They are going to give No Fear the time in the mid lane to kind of get some solo XP.
She just returned to the mid lane.
And I mean, it's already up.
Yeah, if they had Haunt to work with, I feel for
2 seconds and some mana, they'll have it.
You can just TP back to base. Yeah, they want to make the play here. It's going to happen somewhere. It is daytime, but as we know, FY, level 6 already. Just playing like a monster.
These guys. They're going to take their business all the way up towards the top lane here. We check the vision, and they do kind of see something is a bit fishy here, but it might be too late. Yoku tries to pounce to make it away from the trouble, but the damage is already coming. It's on for Aloha Dance. There's a long orb. Can they make it a follow-up for 2 kills? Stun connection there from No Fear. He rolls in trying to slow down Yang, but they have already set their sights for Yoku, and they will get that high priority kill. And look at that. They're going to get rewarded with a 3-man kill. Double kill for Mikasa. VG Gaming Reborn continue their assault, now 8-2 at the start of this one.
Yep, they're just doing every single thing right, and they're even giving levels on DDC. He's going to be up to level 6 on his lion very shortly, and this is looking very bad for Virtus.Pro. That was kind of weird. They felt the gank was coming, right, but yet Slark wanted to go back to the tower. There was no TP rotations just because of the lack of levels, and Invoker just wants to stay in lane and farm. He needs to get up, so he can't really come to these team fights. And I think Slark could have just maybe went to the left, TP'd out, but it looks like they want to contest here. Not having that nighttime available now, this is when Virtus.Pro need to get proactive, and they need to start making things happen.
It's a bit difficult though, with G kind of getting bullied a bit in the mid lane, does suppress his farm quite a bit. And with Yoka committing for the Midas here, does make things a bit greedy on their end, and so they don't really have a whole lot of ammunition to work with in some of these fights to come. And they might have to just kind of put it on hold in the meantime here. It looks like DDC is trying to get a finish here for the tier 1 mid lane. Will anyone show up for Virtus.Pro to deny it? Or is this be a free Lion takedown? He wants it. Well, he's going to have to leave it in deny range. And I think they're just going to roll through and quickly deny it. Okay, so easy deny there from Virtus.Pro. Very nicely done by them. And
they're already smoking up. They have eyes on Invoker here.
They don't care if it's daytime. They're going to continue this. Uh-oh. G's just like, I need to find Bomb somewhere, but they quickly jump. They commit both of the ultimates, the coil, the finger, and that is the end of the Invoker here. Now a roll in from No Fear. Still no level 6 yet, but he gets a nice stun on the both of them. Going to pull through silence here. Mikasa, though, will be able to orb away from trouble.
He's got blink in 3 seconds if needed, and yeah, they just can't chase. I mean, what is with these invis rooms? Another one here for FY. Last one was on Puck.
He's eyeballing No Fear here, but not really going to be going in for. I was going to mention it before. Virtus.Pro were able to get one ward there at the bottom, but they were kind of really sitting in the dark up to this point, while VG have two very deep, aggressive wards, allowing FY to continue to stalk, and he's going to see Aloha dance here. Oh, he's been spotted now. Pops out of the darkness, turns onto him instead, and quickly slaughters apart Aloha Dance with assistance coming in from the ZYF Haunt right now. No Fear in a bit of trouble at this point, but Yoku's here now with FNG, and they quickly look to make the retreat while up and above. They make the go for G, and Invoker's in trouble! And here comes the duo between Yang with the help of the setup and the roar. It's going to allow...
Oh, they are going to be able to get FY here on the backside. So at least they get some rebuttal, but it's...
Mikasa. Orbs right in the face of No Fear as he tries to roll away to safety. For every one little thankful pick off Virtus.Pro is able to get, VG Gaming Reborn continue to get that much more.
They're just having a very hard time of it, just initiating right now for VP. Like, if you look at their lineup, they need to get their farm going early on, and they can't just give away the kills. They need to get something done with that Earth Spirit as well as that Darkseer roaming around early on, and it didn't happen. They're lacking the levels, and then during the team fights, it's like, okay, how do we stun people? How do we get on them? We're just playing very reactive and defensive Dota for VP right now. So this Oracle, even though you did get a lot of kills, onto the Beastmaster, it's just not allowing you for the setups.
Now, nighttime again. This has got to be a bit unnerving if you're Virtus.Pro. Expect them to really deploy the buddy-buddy system at this point. No one can really afford to be out on their own and allowed to be an easy target here for an FY setup. And with Haunt feeling like it's always out there and at the ready, 20 seconds before it's up once again. I just don't imagine Virtus.Pro really going to be able to go on the offensive anytime soon here.
Yeah, I think they can once Earth Spirit can have his level 6, but he's only level 5, and until then, that's their only form of initiation right now for No Fear. Oh, just missing the Sentry Ward. That hurts a lot. I mean, you have the Slark kind of scouting out. They thought there was something on this high ground here, but it was just a Hawk.
Yep.
Yeah, then we see the pickoff there. Haunts.
Oh, and they want to get a hold of No Fear, possibly. No, they'll look to turn back. There's going to be the coil committed. They're going to quickly get G, and they're going to go ahead and take down No Fear. This is just domination coming out from VG Gaming Reborn as they quickly take the lives of 3 once more.
Nice execution so far from VGR in their lineup. Perfect. And just VP, you know, not getting enough done in the early stage, and they're just going around constantly taking them out of their comfort zone, having these deep wards aggressively, and the pressure doesn't stop, and they just have no answer. Even bottom lane here, Yoku going greedily for the tower.
I really want that money, but they're just going to kill him. And they get the tower deny. He's going to try his best to make it out with the Shadow Dance here. Aloha Dance will be there to aid with the help of FNG. And now they're considering a turnaround here for FY. He pops out the darkness, and they're going to be able to burst him down. G finally gets a kill for himself. 1-5 now, assisting with the Sunstrike.
I mean, he's level 8 at 14 minutes in the game. Holy cow, G is not having
a hard game for him.
That one kill, though, giving a lot of money over to the Invokers. He's getting his levels finally. Finally has the 1 point of Wex. Maybe they could use his, you know, Ghost Walk to get away, but they've been on... I mean, Mikasa is just doing everything this game. He's been everywhere, setting up a lot of the kills. Their lineup is very easy to execute with the Haunt now, and as Nahai said, it's just the perfect pickup for them to play very aggressive every single time the Haunt is available. They can't even defend this top tower. There's just no way for them to win a team fight.
They're just gonna have to let that one go here and just try to find their own way for going for some pickoffs. They have the magnetized now up and at the ready for No Fear. So he hustles his way down to rendezvous with the rest of his team. And
they also have the vacuum wall combination mechanisms online. This is as big as Virtus.Pro right now besides Yoku's Blink.
No DDC. Around the corner, they've already made the move for FY. The boulder smash is going to miss. The pounce is also going to miss. And it looks like this game can miss at the end of an hour. The tour coming out from VG.R to Reborn as they commit in the Haunt. But they're going to make vacuum wall combo, and the magnetize is going to be here. Disengage comes out from VG Gaming Reborn, but I don't know if FY is going to be able to make it away. He's good. Gets himself with the urn, and surprisingly, no one going to be going down. But just as I say that, they make their commitment for FSG with Mikasa setting it up. Jumps in, coil follow-up, looking to make a go for a TP. No, yes they can. DDC makes it just in time with the Hex, and it's going to lead to a double kill for FY. That was all started with a Veep. That was a Virtus.Pro gank attempt on the mid lane, and it looked like they had a beautiful setup with a team fight, a vacuum wall combo.
They just didn't save the kick. Like, they used the kick to try and initiate first on FY, but the lockdown is hurting them tremendously right now for Virtus.Pro.
I mean, you can't... You know, you don't get to see it very often except for maybe more of the advanced first spirits, but the commitment on initiating with the roll in, and then as you're rolling in, you can kick a stone forward. Being a lot closer to the target would certainly make it a lot easier to make those connections with the boulder smash, but you know, we're seeing time and time again that the initiating boulder smash is just missing its mark, and then you're down a stun for the fight.
Yeah, but if they had this Blink Dagger last team fight, this would have... I think they would have gotten at least two or three kills, and now they have it.
Another
Once again,
Mikasa. Rune. The theme of the game right now is Mikasa is going to be here. He does not have the coil, but he has plenty of time to wait for it. Just kind of eyeballing the movement here from Virtus.Pro. Will wait before he calls out any sort of rotation from the rest of his team. FY with his boost of early farm, a 6-3-6 performance from him so far. He has the point booster once that Ags comes online.
Yeah, he's 1,000 gold away.
That's just crazy.
I mean, they do have, like I talked about during the draft, they have ways to, like, help against the darkness. It's going to be the Slark giving extra vision, but he realistically needs to be... Well, he's the top of the net worth right now, but he needs, you know, 2-3K more. He's going to have the... It's going to be very hard this game because he still needs to have the BKB, but he also wants some kind of... He wants more stats, and he wants a good, you know, agility item, like, you know, Scotty or... Even the Saint Yasha we saw from Loda the other day isn't too bad, but yeah, you're just gonna get controlled in the team fights. Yoku's desperately trying to find somebody. I think they see them on the low ground there.
Okay, can they make the blow? The Haunt is gonna be pull back wall, kick set up, and they make quick and easy work, taking down the two. FY tries to respond with the darkness, and now they're looking to focus on the enemy. Pass it, nice side. Back Haunt comes out, and VG Gaming Reborn looking for their own responses. They take the Wiser two, make it three with the takedown of FNG. They try to get the catch here, looking to make a grab for Yoku. He blinks away, he pounces out. He's still pinging right on top of him here. He has no TP scroll, and he is just hiding, hugging that tree and praying. Oh, he's again to the north to make it away, but I don't think he could slip away from this one. That is four going down all day from the side of Virtus.Pro. It was a strong and confident start, but good decision to make the buyback.
That buyback worked out perfectly. It'd be nice if they could transition into something now, though. Like, they did get the kills, but since VP are lacking a lot on the levels, they should be responding really soon. And at least you can see what VP can do, right? And their coordination is so on point right now. So I worry still for VG.R if they get picked off more, but VG.R still in the driver's seat here. They don't have the best Roshan lineup, so both of these teams are like, oh, well, even if we get these kills, it's just going to be a bloodbath this game. You can't just get Rosh easily. You can get objectives, but it's only going to be like one tower here.
Yeah.
And then so it's going to be on like, I guess you could say you could get Rosh with the Beastmaster and his Necro 3s as well as his inner beast, but it's not ideal. They don't have enough, you know, minus armor for Rosh just yet. But it looks like this is going to be the second smoke now for VP.
They're like, well, there's no haunt this time. No buyback this time.
Oh, they're just going to dodge it though.
But yeah, it looks to be completely dodged here as they make their movement across the northern part of this map. The rest of VG Gaming are all the way down on the southern front here, back into their own grind of farm. Agnum Scepter is in hand right now for FY and has the gem too. This could leave Virtus.Pro in the dark. We check their map vision right now and it is already pretty damn limited. All things continue to thrive nicely as far as the map control goes for VG Gaming Reborn.
Kind of curious to see what G is going to go for now. He has 2k gold up. He did go for the Blink Dagger last game, but against this lineup, it's so hard to be in an Invoker shoes. You always want to go for that Axe quick rush, but they have so many silences, so many disables that you're forced to go for, you know, can't go Manta style on Invoker, so best option is throw a BKB or Ags, and yeah, it looks like he's still going to go for the Ags here. He's just going to have to position himself really well on the back lines, and you do have the bailout, right? Aloha, he has two potential purges here with the Fortune's End, as well as the False Promise, getting off the silences. He's just going to have to, yep, Aloha dance show. Let's see it.
Looking right now as FY goes stalking about right now. We look at his vision and it's just like a complete radar on this map. Looking to make his sweeps right here. This forces Virtus.Pro in a very timid positioning. And if we look over...
Actually, look at the net worth right now. Look at this. It's only 5,000 considering they're up like 21-7. So it's not that big of a lead as the score kind of like misleads you here.
Yeah, Virtus.Pro do continue to find their own economy gains and grind out the farm in the meantime.
Aloha,
trouble for Aloha Dance. FNG is going to be nearby. He will show himself. They quickly finger and take out the Oracle, and now there's going to be a vacuum wall from FNG. It looks pretty good, but is the follow-up going to be there? They quickly make work of the ducks here as well, and now VG Gaming Reborn can reposition and follow up with the objective here on this Tier 2. Actually, even the Tier 1 is still up, a full Tier 1 at that. So they'll quickly make work of this and maybe even could even push into the Tier 2 as well.
I mean, who makes that play when a Tier 1 tower is still up, right? You just hit, what? They just went so far.
I was like, there's a Tier 1 still up.
And it's like, they were not ready for that at all. Just really good understanding from VG.R. Maybe realizing that, hey, they're probably going to set up on the Tier 2, Tier 3, TP's in. And they just took him by surprise. Earth Spirit not having that combo because of really nice silence coming out from the side of VG.R. And you just see, if you can't get the combos off, it's going to be very hard for VP to take these engagements.
He's still trying to even just get an earn here. It's been a very hard game for the Earth Spirit. And with the help and credit of these very deep offensive wards from VG, they continue to find these great opportunities, and as much as Virtus.Pro would love to just kind of get a D ward out there, it's very difficult against this Night Stalker. Part of the reason why we've been seeing a lot of these Western teams continue to give the respect to teams like LGD and stuff to ban out that Night Stalker. They really just want to make sure that the map control isn't going to be so lopsided one way or the other.
Yeah, you just don't see it often when you have Night Stalker plus Beastmaster. I mean, the Beastmaster can carry you early on with his vision and then Night Stalker in towards the later game. So it's a good synergy between the two. It leaves a lot of focus, right? So they have a lot of single target focus, and what's punished by that is like Alliance or something. You just get pushed, constantly push them, and then they're just going to lose all their towers from VG.R. But in this game, that's not the story. VP's lineup is, you know, fight-oriented, and they just haven't won the fight.
For me, at least, maybe because I could be a bit slower about the things, but when you don't really get to see that until the game is actually starting to be played out, when you recognize that there isn't a lot of push, when you need that kind of push as a counter back here for Virtus.Pro, and now when they're still trying to even take down their second Tier 1 tower of the game, you can just see where the weaknesses really are. Rosh has been taken down. Aegis will be snagged up right now. And look at this, Mikasa feeling pretty good. Goes for the burst damage buildup after grabbing the Yules and the Blink. He goes right for the Dagon here.
could be a bit of a struggle for someone like the Oracle.
Yeah, even ES at this point. As long as Mikasa plays his A game right now, it's going to be so hard for VP to initiate. I mean, the puck can just shut down everything right now for VP. And they can't even really go on him because you said the Yules, there's... You need to have a sheepstick or something on the Invoker or an Abyssal on Slark, and that's not going to happen for a very long time. If VG.R, they do try to go for this high ground, we saw how VP, we talked about it last game, they are the high ground kings. They have a lot to work with.
And they're one of the better high ground defenders you can ask for.
Oh yeah, plus the Invoker. That combo is still there. So, but it's sad though, FNG, he was forced to go for this Guardian Greaves, which... It's nice this game because there's so many silences that he can take off, but you're not having that extra initiation you need with the Blink Dagger. Yeah. So he's just going to have to like surge in, and then at that time it could be thought out or well read.
And for Yoku here, already picking up the ulti up, looks like a Lincoln Sphere will be in order for him. The Hex lockdown potential coming out. Now this blinking DDC Lion, and obviously the silence potential that FY can bring. He'll try his best to build up some defenses to prevent all that CC, but okay, Haunt is out. They commit on in. Boldest Master tries to slow them down a bit, but the coil has already been dropped in with the help of Dagan. They quickly burst out FNG. Alohadez tries to save himself with the False Promise, but it's just going to be an overwhelming amount of damage at this point. And meanwhile, No Fear gets out the Magnetize, tries his best to mitigate a bit of damage, but it's not going to be
there. Also going to set up on Yoku in the mid lane. He's going to be careful.
He already jumps in, gets off the Hex, puts him into a little bit of a froggy here. There's the stun. Mikasa jumps in. There's the finger, and there goes the Slark. 27-7.
Yeah, you just can't go outside of your base if you're VP at this point in the game. If you do, you have to have either maybe a smoke gank up or just very well positioned. And it's hard to position against this team because you see Spectre Haunt giving all that vision. G roared.
Ooh. Gang goes out with a roar. It looked like a bit of a misstep there from VG Gaming Reborn if they wanted to commit, but it doesn't matter. If they misstep, they go in, they get G down. Spectre will lose the Aegis and get a fresh set of life and mana here. But now, as you said, Invoker, no buyback. Going to be taken out of this one. We'll see if VG want to continue to pursue for a push, or it looks like they'll take things and walk away with their huge winnings. Man, now we go over. At first, it didn't feel like one team was really ahead of the other, but now you're looking at a 10k plus advantage in the net worth department, and XP, it's even more dramatic. 15k right now for VG Gaming Reborn.
Yeah, and it's just the Spectre scaling into the later game is going to be so effective against all of these heroes. I mean, there's just no way. You need to itemize against her, and normally that's getting the BKBs for the Desolate, and just none of these heroes are going to have it besides maybe Invoker and Slark, but that's going to take another like 20 minutes or something. They're just forced to stay on their side of the base, and they're just going to have to take a really good team fight. Like, that is the only way back for VP. They can do it. We saw some glimmer of hope this game, but it's going to be very difficult.
In the meantime, it's all VG Gaming Reborn to be able to dictate the pace of this game here. And really not making it anything easy for Virtus.Pro to kind of go outside of their base and find any sort of recovery in front. The second they step out, well, that's going to be a haunt for them. They look to commit in. They dish out the greens. They try their best to survive, but they can't hustle back to the base fast enough here. A Deafening Blast can help, but there goes the roar coming out from Yang. They quickly saw him down. Mikasa with a godlike performance in this one. There goes the finger. Three hit the deck from the side of Virtus.Pro, and here comes the breach from VG Gaming. They make the move for Yoku. Yoku is going to get saved up with the False Promise, and, you know, nice little synergy there between the False Promise and the hefty regen of the Slark should easily keep him alive. But it looks like VG Gaming Reborn will await the next creep wave here and consider going for a siege. 31-7. Very one-sided. Oh! Blinking and missing. Aloha Dance is gone.
Yeah, you just see this vision coming in from Nightstalker. There's just no way they can even walk up. It is daytime, but now you're just going to have, let me just summon that Hawk. And
yep.
With all the heroes dead, it's just so hard for them to see. You just see it. If they just go outside of their base, they just die. And
the vision game here from VG Gaming Reborn is just ruthless. They have wards in all three lanes, it looks like, to scout any sort of movement outside the front door. As you mentioned, the Hawk, we got the Night Stalker. Like, this is just so crippling to Virtus.Pro in the vision game. There's nowhere they can feel safe. Everything they're going to have to do is going to have to be pretty much as a team. And when you have already, when you're already at the point when your team fight just does not seem to really be able to match up, and you look at their draft, they have a huge team fight kind of a draft with your Darkseer, with your Magnetize, with your Invoker, but at this point they're just so flimsy and compared to farm.
And they, the hardest thing for them is just initiating. Like, there's just no way, and you can't really counter-initiate up against the Spectre. It's so difficult.
Necro 3, Blink Roar is going to be up here. There's a jump commitment from Mikasa, gets off a nice coil. The follow-up is going to be the Roar, the stun connection, and we're looking to go for the G. They'll try their best to respond with a vacuum wall combo, but the damage may have been done here as they quickly take down two. Magnetize is going to be going out, but the Dagger Chase is going to continue here, looking to get the grab on for Yoku. No Fear will TP away from trouble. Yoku leaps up to the side shot to make it away, but man, ZYF not letting up, and that is all Virtus.Pro have seen it up. They will throw in the towel in game two. We'll take just about 30 minutes to conclude here. And we're going to be going to game number three.
Yeah, that first game was very close. This one is just a little bit kind of coming down to, you know, you can't even, it's a little bit of the draft there. We saw how Oracle, just not a lion. Like, you have to kind of get on the target, stick on them. You have to get some sort of lockdown. And when we see that Earth Spirit not having a very good early game, and as well as he was coupled with a Darkseer, and you're against a Spectre. That's a hero that can get punished very